The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art most high in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. O God, who as at this time didst teach the hearts of thy faithful people by sending to them the light of thy Holy Spirit, grant us by the same Spirit to have a right judgment in all things, and evermore to rejoice in his holy comfort, through the merits of Christ Jesus our Savior, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the same Spirit, one God, world without end.
Amen. The epistle is written in the second chapter of Acts, beginning at the first verse. When the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. And there were dwelling at Jerusalem Jews, devout men, not of every nation under heaven. Now when this was noised abroad, the multitude came together and were confounded, because that every man heard them speak in his own language. And they were all amazed and marveled, saying one to another, Behold, are not all these which speak Galileans? And how hear we every man in our own tongue, wherein we were born, Parthians and Medes and Elamites, and the dwellers in Mesopotamia and in Judea, and Cappadocia and Pontus, and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, in Egypt and in the parts of Libya around Cyrene, and strangers of Rome, Jews and proselytes, Cretes and Arabians. We do hear them speak in our own tongues the wonderful works of God. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel is written in the 14th chapter of the Gospel according to St. John, beginning at the 15th verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said unto his disciples, If ye love me, keep my commandments. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another Comforter, that he may be able abide with you forever, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him. But ye know him, for he dwelleth with you, and shall be in you. I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. Yet a little while, and the world seeth me no more. But ye see me, because I live, ye shall live also. At that day ye shall know that I am in my Father, and ye in me, and I in you. He that hath my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me. And he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father, and I will love him, and will manifest myself to him. Judas saith unto him, not Iscariot, Lord, how is it that thou wilt manifest thyself unto us, and not unto the world? Jesus answered and said unto him, if a man love me, he will keep my words, and my Father will love him, and we will come unto him and make our abode with him. He that loveth me not keepeth not my sayings, and the word which ye hear is not mine, but the Father's which sent me. These things have I spoken unto you, being yet present with you. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. Ye have heard how I said unto you, I go away and come again unto you. If ye loved me, ye would rejoice, because I said, I go unto the Father, for my Father is greater than I. And now I have told you before it come to pass, that when it is come to pass, ye might believe. Hereafter I will not talk much with you, for the prince of this world cometh, and hath nothing in me. But that the world may know that I love the Father, and as the Father gave me commandment, even so I do. Praise be to thee, O Christ.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The occasion we celebrate today as Pentecost was not, in fact, the first Pentecost. Rather, Pentecost is simply the Hellenistic or Greek name for the Feast of Weeks, one of seven feasts expressly implemented by God during the time of Moses. By God's command, the Feast of Weeks was to take place exactly 50 days after the Feast of First Fruits. So the Feast of Weeks came to be known as Pentecost, the Greek word for 50th. Pentecost was one of three feasts which required all males to appear before the Lord God every year to offer sacrifices.
In Jesus' day, that meant making three annual pilgrimages to Jerusalem. So, just as Jerusalem would have been crowded with pilgrims when Jesus was crucified during Passover, 50 days earlier, so it would also have been crowded with many of those same pilgrims for the Feast of Pentecost. Just 10 days earlier, Jesus had impressively ascended into heaven with a promise to his disciples that they would receive power when the Holy Spirit came upon them. But he gave them no specific information about when that would happen or what that power would be like. We know the answer to those questions from today's epistle. And I find Luke's description of the cloven tongues as of fire especially interesting. Why cloven? What does that mean? Other modern translations say divided tongues, tongues that separated, and tongues as of fire distributing themselves. Many interpreters take this to mean that the Holy Spirit was individually manifested and imparted to those in the room. On that occasion, the outward and visible sign of this was found in the fact that each recipient of the Holy Spirit began to speak in a tongue previously unknown to that recipient, and each understood foreign languages they would otherwise not have been able to understand. So, in addition to filling the entire house generally with the sound of a mighty rushing wind, the Holy Spirit also imparted to each person present a particular gift unique to that person. Holy Scripture teaches that we too receive unique spiritual gifts as determined by the Holy Spirit. Paul addresses this in great detail in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, where he answers a question the Corinthians had posed to him on this very issue. It seems that disputes had arisen among the Corinthians over the nature and value of spiritual gifts, leading in some cases to prideful squabbles and jealousies. Paul throws cold water on that fire, saying, "Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of service, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who empowers them all in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. For to one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, and to another the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another gifts of healing by the one Spirit, to another the working of miracles, to another prophecy, to another the ability to distinguish between spirits, to another various kinds of tongues, to another the interpretation of tongues. All these are empowered by one and the same Spirit, who apportions to each one individually as he wills." Paul then makes the analogy that each gift is a part of a body. And he stresses that without all gifts, no matter how small or great, the body cannot function as intended. So, the person given the seemingly lowly gift of church administration is just as critical as the person given the lofty gift of healing. I think we all understand and subscribe intellectually to this teaching by Paul, but a problem often arises when we try to apply it to ourselves. I have never experienced the Holy Spirit in the form of a mighty rushing wind or a tongue as of fire dancing over my head, and I suspect you have not either. So how do we know that the Holy Spirit is in us? And how do we nurture those gifts that the Spirit has given us? First, we know that the Holy Spirit is in us because Holy Scripture teaches very clearly that this is a gift we receive at baptism. The Apostle Peter said so on that same first Pentecost while preaching to those who had just witnessed the remarkable events of that day, saying, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is for you and for your children, and for all who are far off, everyone whom the Lord our God calls to himself. This indwelling of the Holy Spirit at baptism has always been the teaching of the church, and it is beautifully expressed in Article 27 of the Articles of Religion in our prayer book, which says, "Baptism is not only a sign of profession and a mark of difference whereby Christian men are discerned from others that be not christened, but it is also a sign of regeneration or new birth whereby, as by an instrument, they that receive baptism rightly are grafted into the church, the promises of the forgiveness of sin, and our adoption to be the sons of God by the Holy Ghost are visibly signed and sealed. No baptized Christian should ever doubt, especially in times of trial, temptation, or spiritual dryness, that the Holy Spirit dwells permanently and powerfully in every believer. As Paul says back in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, I want you to understand that no one can say, Jesus is Lord, except in the Holy Spirit. So if you can say those same three words with a sincere heart, then you can also know without any question that the Holy Spirit is in you. But Article 27 does not stop there. It continues with this important instruction. Faith is confirmed and grace increased by virtue of prayer unto God. In other words, the gift of the Holy Spirit at baptism is not an end, it is a beginning. We must nurture and grow the gifts given to us by the Holy Spirit through constant prayer for an increase of that Spirit. And we must also heed Paul's blunt warning in 1 Thessalonians 5:19, do not quench the Spirit. We quench the fire of the Holy Spirit both through sin and through neglect of prayer. I especially like the simple beauty of the alternative collect appointed for this day in the prayer book. Almighty and most merciful God, grant we beseech thee that by the indwelling of thy Holy Spirit, we may be enlightened and strengthened for thy service, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Memorize this short petition and make it part of your daily devotions, and just as surely as if a mighty rushing wind had passed through you and a tongue as of fire had danced over your head, the Holy Spirit will increasingly empower you to fulfill your unique role in the kingdom of God through the gifts he has given you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen. All things come of thee, O Lord.
And of thine own have we given thee.
Amen. Amen. We offer this holy sacrifice to the greater glory of Almighty God in thanksgiving for the passion, death, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Brethren, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
The Lord receive this sacrifice at thy hands to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church.
Amen. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostles has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all those who to confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen. Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession unto Almighty God, devoutly kneeling.
Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ saith unto all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, to the end that all who believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul saith. This is a true saying, and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord. Holy Father, almighty, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, according to whose most true promise, the Holy Ghost came down as at this time from heaven, lighting upon the disciples to teach them and to lead them into all truth, giving them boldness with fervent zeal, constantly to preach the gospel unto all nations, whereby we have been brought out of darkness and error into the clear light and true knowledge of thee and of thy Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let us pray. All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made thereby his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that, his precious death and sacrifice, until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me." Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his past blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present it of thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all the others who shall be worthy to sit, and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. And our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Deliver us, we beseech thee, O Lord, from all evils, past, present, and to come, in the intercession of all ever glories, the Virgin Mary, through the same Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth in thee, in the unity of all else, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
O Lamb of God,
take us away the sins of the world. Have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, take us away the sins of the world. Have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, take us away the sins of the world.
O Lord Jesus Christ, who said to thine apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I leave unto you. This reign is world without end. Amen. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us.
Amen.
See the bread of it. Call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I'm not worthy. Thou shouldst come under my roof. I speak to you. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof. Let's speak to her. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof. Let's speak to her. My soul shall be. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him that taketh away the sins of the world.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, my soul shall be healed. Thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof. Speak the word only.
The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which is given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life.
Amen.
Eat and drink this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be upon you this day and always.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us, who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members in corporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Depart in peace.
Thanks be to God. The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl through the world seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen.
Let us pray. Praised, blessed, and adored be our Lord Jesus Christ, on his most glorious throne in heaven, in the most holy sacrament of the altar, and in the hearts of his faith-filled people. May the souls of the faithful departed through the mercies of God rest in peace.